What a dilemma, shame and bangarang. The story has shifted from Joseph to Judah. And Judah went and married a Canaanite woman named Shua. Now the children of Israel were warned not to mingle or intermarry with the Canaanites in the land. And Judah had three sons with Shua, Onan, and Shelah. And the drama begins. Judah went ahead and got a wife for his first son, But Er was very wicked. He was full of evil, and so God destroyed him. Then Judah went ahead and gave Tamar to Onan, his second son, because he wanted Onan to reproduce with Tamar, because Tamar had no son for Er, and he wanted to ensure that his son's family line continued. Onan agreed to take Tamar as his wife and to have children on behalf of his brother, but he never really wanted that. Instead, he just wanted to enjoy the pleasure that he could get from Tamar. And so whenever they had relationship, he would ensure that she did not get pregnant. And God was not pleased with Onan because he made an agreement that he was willing to have children on behalf of his brother. And also God wanted to ensure that that lineage continued. Therefore, God destroyed Onan too. And so now, Judah has two sons who are dead. Judah told Tamar to remain a widow, and he promised that when his youngest son, Shelah, was old enough, then she could get to marry him. Many years passed, and Judah's wife died. Shelah is now a grown man. But Judah did not fulfill his promise, and Tamar was left a widow. Now one day, Tamar learned that Judah was going to a place called Timnah to shear sheep. So she disguised herself as a prostitute and waited along the road. When Judah came by, he hired her and gave her his signet, a cord, and his staff as collateral until he could send her a goat from his flock. Judah slept with Tamar, and she became pregnant. And even in the midst of all of that, Judah didn't realize that he was having relationship with his daughter-in-law. Now you may be wondering how he did not know that it was Tamar. That was because her face was veiled. Her face was covered. Later, Judah sent the goat with his friend Adullamite. But when he went to search for the prostitute that he described that was in the way, he could not find her. And the persons that he saw in the area said they are not aware of any prostitute being in this area. 3 months later, Judah heard a rumor in his neighborhood. And the rumor was that Tamar, his daughter-in-law, has played the harlot. And she is pregnant. And Judah said, "Bring her forth and let her be burnt." Now, can you imagine Judah making that proclamation after what he did? What we can take from this is that as believers, we should not be too hasty or make it a practice to highlight our brothers and sisters' mistakes. As in this case, Judah too was guilty. So Tamar presented the signet, the bracelet, and the staff, and Judah realized that she was actually pregnant for him. Then he declared, "She is more righteous than I am, because I did not give her Shelah, my son, as I promised." And look at the situation now. It was now time for Tamar to give birth. And when she travailed, one of the child put forth his hand, and the midwife took it and bound it with a scarlet thread, saying, "This came out first." And it came to pass as he drew back his hand, behold, his brother came out, and she said, "How hast thou broken forth? This breach is upon thee." Therefore his name was called Phares. And afterward came out his brother that had the scarlet thread upon his hand, and they called his name Zara. The more I read these stories or events that took place in the past, is the more I understand the grace of God and realize that grace was being extended from the beginning, from Genesis, throughout the entire history of the Bible. Can you imagine Judah, the kingly tribe through which the Messiah is to come? This same Judah is hiring prostitute. This same Judah went and married a Canaanite woman after they were instructed to not mingle with the Canaanites. But God had mercy. And what I loved about Judah is that he was willing to admit, whether it was the evidence of the signet or whatever the case may be, he had a willing heart and he was very remorseful of his actions. And so what we can take from this story is that God is more than willing to forgive us of our trespasses and our sins. He does not hold our weakness and our failures against us. We should also practice as believers not to be hasty in judging others. Because I can imagine how Jacob felt when he heard that she was actually pregnant for Judah. And finally, whatever promise or vow that you make, always ensure that you hold true to your promise. It is better not to vow. It is better not to make a promise. That's it for now for a chapter a day. Let us pray. Father in heaven, God, we thank you that you're a God that continues to extend your grace and your mercies towards your people. Mighty God, you could have wiped us from this earth. But God, you look beyond our faults and you continue to be the good God that you are. I pray, mighty God, that as we learn these stories, God, we will apply them to our hearts. We will not be too hasty to judge each other. We will not be too hasty or excited to declare our brothers and sisters' weaknesses and failures. But God, that we will help to restore, hallelujah, oh great God, so we all can make it. Help us, God, to learn from the experiences of these people that we continue to read about. God, help us to make right choices. Help us not to repeat the same mistakes that they made, because God Almighty, these things are written for our learning so we can live a better life. Grant us favor and forgive us once more, Lord. In Yeshua's name we pray and say thanks. Amen. God bless you. Until next time, walk good.